So many things that the Word of God does, Word of God sets us free. The Lord Jesus says, you know, you will know the truth and the truth will set you free. And he also says that when he's talking to the Father, he says, thy word is truth. So we know that God's word sets us free. God's word cleans us. God's word heals us. God released his word. He said, I release my word and my word will heal them. God's word renews our mind. When we look at Romans chapter 12, we see that, you know, our life is transformed by the renewing of our minds. God's word enlightens us. Scripture declares that the entrance of your word gives light. The word of God builds up faith. Romans 10 and verse 17 talks about how faith comes by hearing and hearing the word of God. The word of God also empowers us. So today we're going to look at how do I get this word into my system, you know, into my life. How he taught many things by parables and said to them in his teaching, listen, behold, a sower went out to sow. And it happened as he sowed that some seed fell by the wayside. And the birds of the air came and devoured it. Some fell on stony ground, where it did not have much earth. And immediately it sprang up because it had no depth of earth. But when the sun was up, it was scorched. And because it had no root, it withered away. And some seed fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it, and it yielded no crop. But other seed fell on good ground and yielded a crop that sprang up, increased, and produced some 30-fold, some 60, and some 100. So the Lord is painting this picture about the sower going out to sow, and different kinds of soil, different kinds of ground, and the outcome of the seed being in different kinds of soil. Matthew 13 and verse 18 says, therefore hear the parable of the sower. When anyone hears the word of the kingdom and does not understand it, then the wicked one comes and snatches away what was sown in his heart. This is he who received seed by the wayside. He who received seed on the stony places, this is he who hears the word and immediately receives with joy. So certain things that we see here happening in operation that's happening. There's a sower, he's sowing the word. Protect that word, protect that revelation, protect that prophecy, that promise, you know, that thing that he has said will happen will in your life, and you know it's been confirmed by two or three witnesses, and you know it beyond a shadow. There's a conviction there in your heart. Yes, this will work. This is what God has said. Our responsibility is to give it that time. It's happening. God is moving circumstances. God is putting things, certain things in place. And he's organizing things. He's setting up divine appointments. And what he said will happen. Mark chapter 4, 26. And he said, the kingdom of God is as if a man should scatter seed on the ground and should sleep by night and rise by day. And the seed should sprout and grow. He himself does not know how. For the earth yields crops by itself, first the blade, then the head, after that the full grain in the head. But when the grain ripens, immediately he puts in the sickle because the harvest has come. So we have a part in gathering the harvest. We'll look at it probably later. You know, how do I do that? But we have a part in that as well. The Lord says, this book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate. Meditate in it day and night. We see that it's different from the worldly meditation. There are two words in the Hebrew which talk about this. Two words. The first one is a word called haga. It's to reflect, imagine, ponder, mutter, to contemplate, to repeat the words. Okay, so I need to ask myself, you know, am I doing that when I, in my quiet time? Siyak, which carries the same kind of meaning, to pray. Three more things about meditation. Three words, actually. Contemplation, visualization, and confession. Contemplation. Psalm 143 and verse 5. The psalmist says, I remember the days of old. I meditate on all your works. I muse on the work of your hands. So to contemplate, to think within ourselves. Second one is visualization, something that the Lord did to Abraham. And the third thing, of course, is confession. Joshua chapter 1 verse 8. This book of law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate. You shall confess. You shall declare it. Deuteronomy 30 verse 14 says, the word is near you, in your mouth and in your heart, that you may do it. So as believers, you know, maybe from tomorrow when we have your quiet time, when we read the word of God, let it not be just a case of reading and forgetting or reading and closing. But let's make space in our lives. Let's make space in our hearts, in our minds, for the word of God to dwell richly. Let's engage with the word of God. Let us be a body of believers who will experience the 30, 60, and the 100-fold. Amen.